The city of Avdat watches from on high over the desert road, linking the Arabian Peninsula and Petra in Transjordan to the port cities of the Mediterranean. The ruins of Avdat, named after the Nabataean king Oboda, attest to its magnificent past. They are a window onto a unique continuity of time periods, royalty, and religions. Over the centuries, as the city flourished, it became renowned in the history of the ancient desert. Avdat was established in the 3rd century BCE as a way station in the heart of the Negev Highlands. The great Nabataean camel caravans from Arabia stopped here, bearing their cargoes of perfumes, spices, incense, and other costly goods. At that time, those wandering Nabataean tribesmen were among the few who dared ply the dangerous routes across the arid expanses. This road, 2,400 kilometers long, which existed from the 3rd century BCE to the 4th century CE, eventually became known as the Incense Route. The Nabataeans were originally tent dwellers, constantly on the move. Their early laws forbade them to plant trees, build homes, or drink wine. But after they became a rich and flourishing commercial kingdom, the rules changed. The Nabataeans learned to channel rain and flood water into plastered cisterns, which they hid well from the prying eyes of strangers. Using the water for agriculture and to quench the thirst of their flocks of sheep and goats, their hold over the desert strengthened. At first, they built forts and way stations along the road, providing food, water, and shelter to the caravan drivers and their camels. Over the years, these way stations became cities like Avdat, one of the most important stops on the incense route. Thus, from a hodgepodge of wandering tribes, the Nabataeans became a powerful, wealthy, and united people, led by a king from his capital, Petra. In 106 CE, the Nabataean kingdom was annexed to the Roman Empire. The change did no harm to its thriving cities. At this time, milestones were set up along the road to mark it for the caravans. Settlement in the Negev reached its greatest prosperity during the Byzantine period. Cities grew, more land was cultivated, and additional roads developed, guarded by forts. The Nabataeans gradually accepted Christianity, and splendid churches were built in the desert cities. Eventually, Greek replaced the Nabataean script. The UNESCO World Heritage Committee has recognized the historical importance of the incense route and the desert cities of the Negev that grew up along it. The committee has inscribed as a World Heritage Site a 65-kilometer-long portion of the road between the Mor Inn and Avdat. Most of this segment of the road, which is open to visitors, passes through the Matzok Hatzinim Desert Nature Reserve. Ideas, religions, new technologies, and cultural values also travel this highway. And so, over the centuries, the incense route became a major influence in bringing together societies, people, and cultures. Most of Avdat's impressive sites are on the city's Acropolis, about 650 meters above sea level and 80 meters above the valley below. On a tour of Avdat, visitors learn about the lifestyle of its inhabitants and how a vibrant city could flourish even in the heart of the desert. Near the visitor center at the foot of Avdat is a wonderfully preserved bathhouse. On the way up the mountain, to the south, is a 3rd century CE Roman burial cave. On top, at the southern end of the city, is the lone Roman villa, commanding a view of the Byzantine agriculture areas. At the city's entrance is the Roman watchtower with its unusual architecture and a lintel bearing an inscription dating from 294 CE. At the foot of the tower is the Byzantine residential quarter, first inhabited during the Roman period. Opposite the gate of the city's fortress is the wine press. The press is often used to make wine in the ancient style. Avdat has 5 such presses, attesting to a thriving winemaking industry in the Byzantine period. Within the city walls are 2 impressive churches built using stones taken from Avdat's Nabataean temples. The lookout platform at the northwestern end of the city stands over the ruins of the Nabataean temple. It reveals a spectacular view of the city's slopes and the expanses of the Negev Highlands. The western slope is riddled with caves carved into the limestone behind some of the hundreds of houses that once stood here. The caves served as tombs, dwellings, and storerooms. Avdat was abandoned followed an earthquake at the beginning of the 7th century CE. But its silent remnants and the incense route that led here continue to tell the story of a unique culture that brought the desert alive and ruled it for centuries. Please help us protect Avdat National Park for you and for the generations to come.